This is Kenneth Turan of the Los Angeles Times, and this is my DVD pick of the week. This week I'm going to highlight the work of two of the greatest actor-comedians of the 1930s and onward, William Powell and Myrna Loy. If you're a film buff, you think of them in terms of a Thin Man and a whole series of Thin Man films. They were a great team, sharp, funny, just a treasure to see together. And Warner Archives now has two of their other films, non-Thin Man films, out on DVD. The first one, the most legendary, is Manhattan Melodrama, where they co-star with Clark Gable. It's the first time Powell and Loy were on the screen together. Their chemistry here is what got them the Thin Man parts. And this film is notorious because it's the film John Dillinger, the great 1930s gangster, was watching right before he was gunned down by federal agents.
Here, take it. Okay, buddy. That's for luck.
Morning, darling.
Good morning. You look tired. Didn't you sleep well?
I haven't slept yet. I've been at the office until now with plenty to do. Honey, Snow was murdered last night in Madison Square Garden.
Snow murdered?
Oh, my dear, I'm so sorry. I shouldn't
have... It mustn't be. It can't be, Jim.
Well, darling, the man's been asking for it. He's made hundreds of enemies. But he shouldn't upset you, dear.
Oh, no. I guess it just must be the relief. Hello? Yes? Police headquarters? It's for you.
Wade speaking. What? All right, I'll be down in just a little while.
What is it?
They made an arrest.
Who?
Blackie.
Nice of you to come and see me like this. Put you in a lot of trouble. Crazy to come here. Suppose somebody spotted you. You can see the headlines now. DA's wife in secret visit to Slayer. That'd be fine.
But I had to come, Blackie. It's because of what I said to you at Belmont. You said you'd do something about Snow.
You got it all figured out, haven't you? Hey, look. What are you going to wear on the witness stand?
Blackie, please. I haven't told Jim yet. I wanted to see you first.
And I thought you were smart. That's what I always liked about you. You're even smart enough to walk out on me.
But I'll have to tell him.
That's great. The one thing they haven't got on me is a motive. So the DA's wife pops out with a pip.
But Jim will understand. Jim will help you. Blackie, you've got to tell me. Did you kill Snow?
Oh, don't be silly. You don't kill rats like Snow. You don't have to. Hey, look. Tell me something.
What?
You in love with Jim?
I love Jim more than anything else in this world. I never knew what love was, Blackie, until I met Jim.
All right. And if you love Jim as much as you say you do and you want to see him, Governor, keep quiet. Hey, look, you don't know that guy as well as I know him. Above everything else in the world, he's the district attorney. Remember that. Now, if you tell what happened to Belmont, he'll put you on the witness stand. And then where'll he be when he comes to his campaign for governor?
Well, what about you? It's your life.
They haven't got a thing on me as long as you keep quiet.
You know, Blackie, for a while, I was almost ashamed of having loved you. But I'm not now. I'm proud.
Yeah? Well, I think you're okay, too.
Time's up.
Okay. So long, Eleanor.
Goodbye, Blackie.
The other film is less dramatic. It's called I Love You Again. It's got a wacky plot about amnesia and confidence men, but it's also got Powell and Loy trading wisecracks, and that is always a treat.
I think we better get right to the hotel and see if the bank has sent the...
Yoo-hoo!
What's the matter?
Boy, 18 days alone on a boat is certainly a long time to be alone on a boat for 18 days.
What are you talking about?
Take a look. Some dish? What else she's waving to?
Keep your mind on your work.
Larry? Are you all right?
Oh, yes, I'm fine. How are you?
Well, the paper said you were injured.
Oh, no, nothing serious. You know how papers are. Well, it certainly is good to see you.
I know you're surprised.
Surprise isn't a word for it. Yes, sir, it certainly is good to see you.
Come on, let's go.
Oh, this is Doc Ryan. Yes, good old Doc.
How are you, Dr. Ryan?
I'm much better now, thanks to him.
Habersville is pretty proud of that rescue.
Good old Habersville. Did you just leave?
When I read that you were hurt, I didn't know how seriously. Naturally, I had to come.
Naturally, yes. Well, it certainly is good to see you.
So you said.
It's worth repeating.
Larry, you seem strange.
Oh, well, that's just because you haven't seen me for a while. Before you know it, we'll be right back where we were.
That's another thing I came to see you about.
Oh. I'll go look after our luggage. I'll leave you in care of the doctor.
Dr. Ryan, is he really all right?
Well, you see, lady, he's had a pretty thorough shock. Now, you just give me your name and telephone number, and the minute he feels better, I'll have him call you.
Call me?
Yeah, he'll ring you in a couple of days.
Oh, thank you, doctor. But do you know who I am?
Well, whoever you are, he needs rest and quiet. Now, if you're a friend of Larry's...
I'm his wife.
His wife. Oh, yes. How stupid of me.
Well, all set. Boy's got the bags.
I was just saying, what a lucky girl this is to have you for a husband.
Oh, I wouldn't say that.
What is it? What's the matter?
Nothing. I'm fine.
No, you're not. You're sicker than you think. You need a lot of rest and quiet.
Oh, I'm all right. Just a day or two in bed.
Larry, are you sure you can walk? Maybe we can find a wheelchair.
Oh, no. I'm all right. If I could just lean on you a little.